So, hey Deja, thank you so much for being here today. So, Deja is our 1920 Pioneer Star, and she wrote It Is What It Is and worked with that for her single for being our Pioneer Star with Pioneer Records. So, tell us a little bit about the song, what it's about, and that process of writing it and actually recording it in that studio.
So, as far as writing and recording it, it was a pretty fast process. I think I went to 3 sessions in total. So the first one was the beat, like the vibe or feeling that I wanted to give. And then the second one was, it was kind of like a rough draft of the song. I probably didn't have even all the lyrics at that time. And then the last one was the final, you know, cutting of the vocals, et cetera, et cetera. As far as what it is about. I would say, like, it's like the conclusion of 2019. Yeah. Was that 2019? Yeah, the end of 2019. So yeah. It was like my conclusion of everything that I went through that year. And it's like, hey, it is what it is.
I'm excited to hear that It Is What It Is of 2020, because that's going to be a whirlwind of a song. I cannot believe.
2022 is going to be crazy.
Speaking of 2020 and COVID and things, how has your music been and what kind of different paths have you taken since you might not be able to perform as much live or do venues like that?
Well, all of my shows, including my album release party for Flyers and Death and Me, were canceled. Like, everything. It was.
I know. So many things. Like, my heart just broke when they canceled. I was like, no.
Like, I was just really just heartbroken, but as far as the shows, they all got canceled. We tried to release the music. I dropped the album. So we tried to release that in the best way that we could. So it was all through social media. Couldn't do any videos because COVID.
And right.
Yeah, as far as like my music writing process, I think being at least for like March into like April and May, you're just in the house 24/7. Mm-hmm. You know, it's hard to write when you're just looking at the four walls of your room. So that I wasn't really writing, but whenever I started to go outside just a little bit, I started to write a little bit. I started to come up with new ideas for what I'm going to do next, you know.
That's awesome. Yeah, I remember your like iconic little freestyle about being stuck inside. It's still one of my favorite things, and it's relatable the longer and longer quarantine goes on.
Thank you.
I love to hear it. So with your music, who kind of inspires your sound and vibe? Like artists, like your family, like what's really the main driver when it comes to like what you want to say with your music?
As far as like the genre and the sound, I'm like a cusp 90s, 2000s baby. So All of my music, I feel like kind of reflects that. I've heard a lot of people say that it sounds like 2000-y. So yeah, I would say like early Sierra, you know. I'm not, in my head, like I don't really know all of the names, but.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I would say it's inspired by the generation that I grew up in. As far as the content, like I try to keep it as honest and as real as possible to my life. So as far as like Flowers and Dopamine and It Is What It Is, you know, those were real life experiences. So I don't really know what else to write, but those.
Definitely. So with all of that, what's next? What is the next big thing you want to do to further your career in music? I know you're already working hard and keeping stuff out and keeping your name in the loop. Like who do you want to work with? Who's the big next move?
So I think the next move is videos because I didn't get to do videos because of COVID.
Yeah.
I'm trying to like figure out how I can make it still relevant. So videos definitely, and as far as projects, I really want to drop an EP next. Well, really 2 new EPs. That's what's in the works right now. And I want to do a lot more collaborations because I didn't have, well, I had 1, I think, or 2 collaborations on Flyers and Dopamine. Mm-hmm. So.
Speaking of a music video, a part of your Pioneer Star process was that you got to record a music video for It Is What It Is. How did that go? How did working with the cinema class go? What was your vision for that? And what are we going to see from your perspective with it?
So that was really great. Like, I've had experiences with, like, dealing with media crews and just dealing with the team. But I don't think I ever dealt with a team that was solely focused on something that I wanted to do. So that was cool. We had a lot of meetings about like what I wanted to envision or what I wanted to portray. And yeah, and it's so crazy because we recorded all of it right before COVID hit, like right before COVID hit. So
that's a miracle.
Yes, like we had to get everything together in a faster pace than we would have. Yeah. But it was great. Like, it was really fun. Everyone was really nice. Okay. As far as the video, I think it's going to show, like, me coming out on top. It's like the conclusion, how I was saying earlier, to where mm-hmm. it shows a lot of different depictions of a conclusion, if that makes sense.
I love it. I'm excited to see it, and I'm excited to see more of your work and more of your videos. Yeah, COVID is hard, but it's creating a new normal for the music business, and I think we're going to figure it out, and we're going to, like, more and more content is just going to be so creative and new, I really think. So thank you so much for joining us today. Always so happy to see you. I'm excited for It Is What It Is and the video and all that fun stuff. So.